Well, friends, already we are learning the lesson, making of a scientist. We have seen first part of the lesson, in that we have seen how Richard Ebright was. In the beginning, when he was very small, that time he had a hobby to collect butterflies. He has collected many things like coins. So he was an astronomer. He was gazing at the sky. And likewise, many instruments his mother has brought for him. Also, he went for the trips, mountaineering, and that also instrument he had. Then how he was as a child, that we have seen. Now we will see, and also we have seen how he was collecting the butterflies. Then he got bored with that, and then afterwards when he thought that, when he collected around 25 species of the butterfly, and then he thought that now I'm not getting different kind of species of the butterfly, you know, around reading is the name of the particular village where he was living, and that is why he wanted to stop. But his mother has given one book, that Monarch 10 or X, that book he has got. And at the last point of the book was that they have to miss one of the person who was told him that you have to find out the butterflies who had and they have to tag it, that butterfly they have to tag and they have to leave it. And when and those suppose somebody will get that tagged butterfly, then they have to send to the Frederick sir. Okay, till that we have seen, and he has worked for around many years for that, and he could manage to find a butterfly which he has tagged. Only two butterflies he has tagged, and when he has seen that, how many kilometers it has, that Monarch has traveled, then it was around 75 miles, and then he got bored. Then why should I do that, like that, he got a little discouragement, till we have seen. So eventually I began to lose interest in the tagging butterfly, that is, it is tedious, it is very tiring, and there is not much feedback. Okay, Ebright said, in all the time I did it, he laughed, only two butterflies I had tagged were recaptured, and they were not more than 75 miles from where I had lived. So that is the thing which made him bored, and that is why he becomes so tiresome, he has root out his interest from that. Now we'll see the next part. Then in the 7th grade he got the hint of what real science when he entered a country science fair, and he was in 7th standard, class 7, 7th grade. That time he understood about the real science. He has taken part in the one of the science fair, and he has lost that. Unfortunately, he has lost that science fair. He couldn't get any rank in that science fair. It was really a sad feeling to sit there and not getting anything, while everybody had got much prizes there, many prizes. That is why it was a very sad moment in his life, that Ebright said. His entry was slides of the frog tissues, and what he has presented there, some decoration, some actual fact he has presented in the form of slides. And others have presented some real experiment, and that is why they won. And that he understood, that if I want to succeed, I have to present certain real experiment. And what he did, his entry was slides of the frog tissues, which he showed under the microscope. It was very, very easy task, and it was very simple. That is why he couldn't get the number, he couldn't get the prize in that. He realized that the winner had tried to do real experiment, not simply make a neat display. What he had done, he had only displayed whatever the fact was. But they have done some real experiment, and that is why they were winner. That he understood. Already the competitive spirit that drives Richard's Ebright was appearing, and when he understood that, because he has introspect himself and what others have done. So by this we can understand he has the competitive nature. But it was not bad competition, because he was trying to find out something where he was lacking. Okay. I knew that for the next year's fair, I would have to do a real experiment, he said. He said that I have to do real experiment, then only I will get some prizes there. The subject I knew most about was the insect work. I had been doing in the past several years, and he was just doing something with the insect that we have seen, that how he is collecting the butterflies and all. So he wanted to do on in that particular field only. Then so he wrote Dr. Urquhart for idea. Then back came a stack of the suggestion for the experiment, and then he couldn't know, nobody was there who was resource person for him. That is why he had written to Frederick sir, and that is why, and he has got many suggestions from him. Those kept Albright busy all through high school and led to prize projects in the country and international science fair. And then he got many ideas from the Frederick, and that is why he can win many contests after that. For his eighth grade project, Albright tried to find the cause of a viral disease that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. And then he kept the subject for the science fair, that how and why many monarch caterpillars have been died by which disease. Albright thought the disease might be carried by the beetle. Beetle is one of the insects. He tried raising caterpillars in the presence of the beetle, and what he did, he had kept some caterpillars in front of the beetles because he wanted to find out the root cause of that viral disease. How those monarch caterpillars get died. That is why he kept those monarch caterpillars in front of the beetles. I didn't get my any real result, he said, but I went ahead and showed that I had tried the experiment. This time he won, and I won, he has mentioned. And actually he didn't get the response, he didn't get the result, real result behind it, how it is. But he tried, he has explained that I have tried real experiment, and that is why he has won that. The next year, his science fair project was testing the theory that viceroy butterflies copy monarch. These are the different butterflies, monarch and viceroy. Okay, so if you see that if in our particular area we get the viceroy butterfly, which has certain like this, we can see like this butterfly, we can see this is monarch, it is viceroy, and which is monarch. Monarch has certain like this, means it has this way, body structure of the monarch is like this. So most of the bird like to eat this viceroy because they do test well, and monarch are having little slanting wings, and that is why they don't eat those butterflies. It is those pictures are given in the book, you can see it neatly, so you will understand better because my drawing is not that good. Okay, boys and girls. So the theory was that the viceroy looks like monarch because monarch don't test good to birds. Viceroy on the other hand do test good to birds. So viceroy becomes the dinner or food for the birds. Okay, so what viceroy does, they try to look like a monarch, because monarch is not the monarch type of butterfly, not that the first choice of birds for his prey. Okay, so the less likely they are to become a bird's dinner. Albright's project was to see whether in fact birds would eat monarchs. He found that the starling, one of the birds, starling would not eat ordinary bird food, because most of the birds are eating viceroy butterfly because they do test well, and they don't eat monarch because they don't test well. But ordinary means like that one starling bird eat monarch. Albright said that later research by other people showed that viceroy probably do copy the monarchs. This project was placed first in the zoology division and third overall in the country science fair. And this particular experiment he has kept in the zoology and then zoology division and third over in the country science fair. So this experiment he has kept for the science fair, and he had got the first rank and third rank. Again, I repeat this. Albright project was to see whether in fact birds would eat monarchs. That was the name of the project. That was the project. He found that a starling would not eat ordinary bird food. It would eat all the monarchs it could get. This is the one bird which eat monarch. But normally, viceroys get eaten by many other birds. Albright said later research by the other people showed that viceroy probably do copy the monarch. Okay, viceroy, what they do the copy of the monarch. They look like they try to make their wings little slanting like a monarch. So they do like, they look like monarch. Okay, Viceroy. This project was placed first in the zoology division. This project, particular project, got first rank in the zoology and the third rank in the country science fair. Then we'll go further. In his second year in high school, Richard Ebright began the research that led to his discovery of the unknown insect hormone. And then Now, insect also has hormones, like it is also a living being, it is also a living thing. So it also secretes some hormones, and indirectly it also led to his new theory of the life of cell. And this was his discovery, and this is the new invention, this is the new discovery about the life of cell. The question he tried to answer was simple: what is the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spot on the monarch pupa? And we can see that there are certain 12 golden round spot on the pupa. What is the what exactly the meaning of that? What is the use of that? It was a simple question. Everyone assumed that the spots were just ornamental, look like, because of that spot, golden spot, that particular butterfly or that pupa looks very good, attractive. That will be the, that was the answer from many. But Dr. Urquhart didn't believe it. Miss Patrick didn't believe it. To find the answer, Ebright and another excellent science student first had to build a device and show that the spots were producing a hormone necessary for the butterfly's full development. And then Richard Ebright and his friend, they have made one device to show that that particular gold 12 spots is made for, it secretes some hormones, and which that particular hormones is necessary to development of the butterfly. So that was that. So it was great discovery. Okay, this project won Ebright first place in the country fair and entry into the international science and the engineering fair. You can understand, when he was very small, that time he lost that, when he has put the slides of the frog tissues under the microscope, and then he understood that I have to present real experiment, and then after that he didn't look back. He is getting awards and awards and awards. So by this we can understand he was very determined and he was very consistent in his progress. Okay, so for this he has got the first rank, okay, in the international science and engineering fair. He got an entry there, and he got the first place in the country fair and entry into the international science and engineering fair. There he won third place for zoology. There also he won the third place. He also get a chance to work during the summer at the entomology laboratory of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. There also he got the chance to work. As a high school school junior, Richard Ebright continued his advanced experiment on the monarch pupa. Now he got at one particular topic to make on research. And there he, what he did? That year his project won the first place in the international science fair and gave him another chance to work in the army laboratory during the summer. And there also he got the prize, and he got another chance to work in the army laboratory. In this senior year, he went a step further. He grew cell from a monarch wing in a culture. What he did? He grew a cells from a monarch wing in a culture, and he did that and showed that the cells would divide and develop into the normal butterfly. Okay, but wing scales only if they were fed the hormone from the gold spot. And he has concluded by his experiment, if he had done it in the culture, that cells development in the culture, if the cell get hormones from that particular gold spot, then only butterfly develop itself. That he has concluded through his experiment. This, that project won the first place for the zoology and the international fair. He spent the summer after the graduation doing further work at the army laboratory and at the laboratory of the US Department of the Agriculture. There also he studied. The following summer, after his freshman year at Harvard University, Ebright went back to the laboratory of the Department of the Agriculture and did more work on the hormone from the gold spot, and he got the particular field to work on, and that is why he was keep on working on the same thing. He didn't leave that topic. He worked on the gold spot of the pupa using the laboratory, sophisticated instrument. Now he is getting most advanced laboratory to work on, and he has worked with the sophisticated instrument from the laboratory. So he got a keen observation. He was able to identify the hormone's chemical structure. Now first he understood that there are certain 12 gold spot on the pupa. Then he understood that this is nothing but the hormone from there, hormone secreted, and which is helpful for the development of the butterfly. After that, he has seen the structure of that particular gold spot. Okay, using the laboratory instrument, he was able to identify the hormone's chemical structure, what hormone it was secreting there. So that structure he could identify with the sophisticated instrument from the laboratory. A year and a half later, during his junior year, Albright got the idea from his new theory about the cell life. What is the theory? It came while he was looking at the X-ray photos of the chemical structure of the hormone, and he was looking at the, and one new theory he has got, we will see that what is the new theory. But when he was looking at the X-ray of the structure of the hormone, when he saw those photo, Albright didn't shout eureka or even I have got it. You know that we have certain experience, we have certain evidences. One of the scientists say eureka, or I found it, or something he didn't say, but he believed that along with his findings about the insect hormones, the photos gave him the answer to one biology puzzle, and that particular photo have given the answer to many biologists puzzle. That no particular thing was not solved, it was unsolved, but by the photo they understood. What we will see further, how the cell can read the blueprint of the DNA. What was that? How the cell can read the blueprint of the DNA. What is DNA? So DNA is a substance in the nucleus of the cell that controls the heredity. DNA is the substance in the nucleus of a cell that controls the heredity. You know better, you have learned in the science. And what it does, it determines the form and the function of the cell. It determines the form and the function of the cell, and DNA is the blueprint of life. So he understood the DNA of the cell, okay? So that is why he determines the form and the function of the cell. This was the theory he has found out when he was looking at the structure of the hormone, okay? We'll see that. Albright and his colleague, college roommate, James R. Wong, worked all that night drawing pictures and constructing plastic models of the molecules to show that how it could happen. Together they later wrote the paper that explained the theory, and they were just thinking about, they have made the pictures and they have written the theory regarding this DNA. Surprisingly, no one who knew him, Richard Albright, graduated from the Harvard University with the highest honor, that he has passed with the graduated. He has graduated from the Harvard University with the highest honor, second in the class of the 1510. Albright went to become the graduate student researcher at the Harvard Medical School as well. And then there he began doing experiments to test his theory. And he was completing his studies also, and he was making the experiment on the test of his theory, DNA. If the theory proves correct, it will be a big step towards the understanding the process of life. Suppose this theory proved correct, which one? DNA. The DNA is a sustainable in the nucleus of the cell that controls the heredity, and then it determines the function, form and the function of the cell. Okay, if it is true, that will change the all things in the science, pursuit of life. It might also lead to new ideas for the preventing some types of cancer or other dangerous diseases also. So this is very big structure which he has understand there, and that is why all of this possible because of the Albright's scientific curiosity. He was looking with the some sophisticated instrument from the laboratory, and that is why he understood. His high school research into the purpose of the spot on the monarch pupa eventually led him to this theory of the cell life. And theory of the cell life he understood because he was just minutely observing the that gold spot which was on the body of butterflies. Then he went to the, then he understood the hormones which was secreting from that, and then he has studied the structure of the hormones, and then he understood that DNA, and DNA controls, determines the form and the function of the cell or cell, and then DNA is the blueprint of the life that he understood. Then we will understand about his how Richard Abel was the interested in science. He first began collecting butterflies, that we have understood. He trying to collect butterflies, then but not so deeply that he hasn't time for other interests. Abel also a great debaters. So he was not only restricted himself in a particular science section only, no. He was good debater, he was a public speaker, he was good canoeist. The name canoeing is skillful canoeing. He can pedal it. And he was all-rounder sport person, and he was expert photographer as well. So don't stop there that Richard Albright was only collecting things, or he was thinking about a butterfly, but he had many things in his character, in his personality. He was champion debater, he was a public speaker. It's very difficult to be a public speaker, because speaking is a very great skill, and you need to acquire good skill when you are going to speak somewhere. Okay, you must be very correct, you must be very clear, and you must be reaching at the audiences. If it is possible, then only can be a good public speaker. Champion debater, debater, you have to do study a lot. Okay, minutely you have to study, then only can debate others, because you have to prove yourself correct. So you need some surrounding information about that particular topic. And he was a good canoeist, one of the skill and all-rounder. He is a all-round outdoor person, and last one, he is an expert photographer, because he had great observation skill. He wanted to see everything. He has keen. That is why he has found that 12 tiny golden spot. That is what the photographer. So by this we can understand he was a photographer, because he has seen it very minutely, and then he understood the theory of the cell. So he was a great photographer. So other things also were there, particularly of nature and scientific exhibit. In high school, Richard Albright was a straight A student. He was very straight A student, because learning was easy. He turned a lot of his energy towards the debating and model United Nations National Club. He also found someone to admire. So one person he has got, Richard A. Wehrer, his social studies teacher and advisor to both clubs. Mr. Wehrer was the perfect person to me then. Me means Richard Albright. He was a very perfect guy who admired Richard Albright, whoever has admired. He openly mind to new ideas, Albright said. He opened my mind for the new ideas. So for Albright, Weber was a great admirer. And Weber had opened, okay, new ideas for Richard Albright. So what he said, Weber, about Albright, that Richard would always give him that extra efforts. You know, that whenever you want to become successful in one of the thing, you need to put extra efforts. Now you are in class 10, so you are making extra efforts for that. And if you will not put, you will not get desired result. And suppose you will put extra efforts, surely you will get desired efforts. So suppose you want to get something special, you need to put extra efforts in that. Mr. Weber said, what pleased me was there was this person who put in 3 or 4 hours at night doing debate research, beside doing all the research with butterflies and his other interests. So whenever he want to take any thing in his hand, he used to put many effort for that. That was a good thing. Richard was competitive. Richard was, Albright was very competitive, because we have seen that how he lost the competition, and again afterwards he has lost many, you know, Indian country science fair, then divisional, then zoology, then many international also he has, engineering also he has. So we can understand his competitive nature, but it was not bad competition. Nowadays, if we see today's scenario, that there is a great bad competition where people want to, this person want to win something, win something, and for that sake he can do anything. Okay, there may be bribe, there may be something like a ill plan, cunning plan to destroy someone else because I want some victory, that is why. But he was not, that competition was not bad one. So Richard was, he has a competitive, but Mr. Wither continued, but not in the bad sense. Okay, so he explained Richard wasn't interested in winning for sake of winning to get a prize. So that was the ultimate thing for him, to get prize. Winning for the winning. Why I want to win? Because I want to get prize. No, that was not the behind. Rather, he was winning because he wanted to do the best job he could. That is what we have to learn from him. That is why we can say the making of a scientist. This is what we want in our character. That it is not for the, suppose you want to do something, I want to get first rank, I want to win first rank, only for that sake? No. Because you want to do the best in the class 10th. That is what. Okay, it is very special rhyme. We can see, but not in the bad sense. He explained Richard wasn't interested in winning for a winning sake or winning to get a prize. Rather, he was winning because he wanted to do the best job he could. See, he wanted to pick out the best thing from himself. For the right reason, he want to be the best. For the right reason, he want to be the best everywhere. Because he just tried to put efforts, almost all efforts there. And that is the one of the ingredients in the making of a scientist. And that is the key factor in his character. And that is why he became a scientist. Because he wanted to find out, put out, come up, bring out the best from his activity. Start with the first rate mind and curiosity and mix in the will to win for the right reason. Everett has these qualities from the time the book The Traveled Monash X opened the world of the science for him. You know that in the beginning we have seen that when he was bored, he was discouraged, that when he has collected around 25 pieces of the butterflies, and afterwards he thought that whenever he used to go for the catching bird butterflies, he used to see that okay, similar. So he wanted to stop there, but that time his mother has brought one book, what is the name? The Travels of the Monarch X, and that has opened the world of science to him, and that is why he progressed. Richard Everett has never lost his scientific curiosity, and he never lost his scientific curiosity till the end. He was totally devoted to himself for the science. So that is why this is what the story of making a scientist. What we have learned in this lesson, that Richard Everett, who was depicted by Robert W. Peterson, has depicted the character of Richard Everett. How was Richard Everett? At the initial stage, you can see he was collecting things. He has hobby to collect things, and he has collected 25 pieces of the butterflies. Then afterwards, as we gradually move forward in the lesson, we can understand he was a champion debater, public speaker, good canoeist also, all-round outdoor person also, and he was expert photographer. And what is the thing which he had? He never win for the prize. He wanted to win to take out something best from his character. That is why. And which was the turning point in his life? That when he stopped his hobby to catch the or to collect the butterflies, that time his mother has brought the book, and it has transformed his life. And that is why he goes further and further, and he succeeded. One ultimate thing was that he never stopped his curiosity. That made him the scientist. So we have seen the story making of the scientist. I hope that you have understood this story. Thank you.